It was 20 years this month when Melvin Ignatow finally admitted killing his ex-fiancee, Brenda Sue Schaefer. And that was a heinous crime and one people still talk about to this day.
Through the Freedom of Information Act, WLKY obtained the FBI files on this case. WLKY investigative reporter Steve Bergen has covered Ignatow since 1998 and has more.
We, the jury, find the defendant, Melvin Henry Ignatow, not guilty.
Despite an eyewitness to the crime and an FBI secretly recorded conversation about the murder, Melvin Henry Ignatow was acquitted of killing ex-fiancee Brenda Sue Schaefer. While federal authorities were investigating Schaefer's 1988 disappearance as a kidnapping, they caught Ignatow's accomplice, Marianne Shore, in a lie and convinced her to testify. But jurors did not find her believable. Their verdict came down just before Christmas, 1991.
Feels great. I think it's the greatest Christmas present I've ever had.
Shore testified that at the direction of Ignatow, she snapped photographs of Schaefer tied to a glass-top coffee table where she was raped and sodomized. Ignatow killed Schaefer, then placed the body in a shallow grave.
He dug her grave weeks before he killed her, so it was a very methodical and just evil crime.
The photos could not be located before the murder trial. Also missing, thousands of dollars of jewelry belonging to Schaefer. FBI investigative documents obtained by WLKY through an open records request show experts believe the key evidence was still around.
We knew from the behavioral science people at Quantico that the film and the jewelry, which Marianne Shore, our primary witness, had told us about, would probably still be in existence.
The FBI's so-called Silence of the Lambs unit began profiling Ignatow days after Schaefer's disappearance.
The photographs would represent a trophy to him later, something he could view, you know, in the future.
Federal files show the trail even led investigators to Hong Kong, where Ignatow had business ties. There were rumors he was a smuggler of drugs and money, both unsubstantiated. At one point, Ignatow suggested Schaefer was suicidal. One thing he did not lie about, he was the last one to see her alive. Even though acquitted of murder, federal authorities pursued a perjury case contending Ignatow lied about his involvement in Schaefer's death. Thomas Clay represented Ignatow and was optimistic about the federal case. But that all changed the evening of October 1st, 1992.
Well, it's a night I'll never forget.
A week before the perjury trial was scheduled to begin, Ignatow's luck ran dry.
Actually, I got a call from you that night indicating that the people who had bought the house for Mr. Ignatow had pulled up the carpet and found a vent that had been concealed by the carpet.
This was confiscated hit from him.
10-1.
Former FBI agent Ed Armento was assigned to retrieve three canisters of film and jewelry found by a carpet layer in this Eastern Jefferson County home once shared by Ignatow and his mother.
We processed the film. As soon as the film was processed and the photographs started coming out, I knew that we had Mel Ignatow.
There were 105 photographs, which turned out to be photographs of what Mel Ignatow had done to Brenda Schaefer on the night he murdered her.
Did you see them?
I did. And they were graphic and they were gruesome.
Within 24 hours, Ignatow was pleading guilty to federal perjury charges.
What did you think when he stood up before a federal judge and said, she died peacefully?
You know, at this point, there was nothing that would surprise me what this guy would do. You know, and I think he genuinely thought, if I say that to her family, you know, they'll totally forgive me. It'll all be okay. I mean, that's what a sick guy he was.
He is the man who got away with murder, but he did not totally escape justice. Ignatow spent time in jail awaiting trial for killing Schaefer. He spent 10 years in prison on separate federal and state perjury convictions. In September 2008, the 70-year-old Ignatow fell into a glass-top coffee table at his apartment off Bardstown Road and bled to death. Steve Bergen, WLKY News.
Thank you, Steve. Now, we have the entire FBI file from the Mel Ignatow case on our website. Just go to the top story section of WLKY.com.